Hello everybody, I'm Togashi, and welcome to another review of a Ruby chapter. This time we are reviewing Volume 5, Chapter 9, A Perfect Storm, and I'm looking there because that is where I can see the title that I didn't remember. But I reacted to this blindly, as usually, so you can check the links down below. My blind reaction is there, the original Roostatis version is there as well. So you can come back after you've seen them. But let's talk about what happened here. Because there are actually not too many things happening, but very meaningful ones. First of all, we knew that Cinder is going to meet Riven. But I was sure that they were gonna fight. But again, I forgot that Riven is not... actually doesn't want her tribe to be extinguished. She even stopped Yang and Weiss from fighting. So, yes, I forgot that fighting is actually just gonna call more cream into the area, and that would make things not that happy for the clan. And obviously, now that Cinder knows, and that means Salem knows as well, where the clan is, they have to get out and go away. But she didn't have too much choices. She either is with Salem or against Salem. Well, that's the two things. And as Cinder said, she is only alive because she has the Spring Maiden. That is the only reason. But it seems like that she actually, Cinder, actually like hungry for my power. At least it seems like it. I don't know. I don't trust that they just only want, yeah, we only want the relics. That might be one of the, that's true, they want the relics, or the relic. But they are not gonna just let them go after that. They are probably gonna just steal the Spring Maiden's power as well. And I don't know if one person can hold more power, more magic than one. Because if that's true, I saw that from Cinder Eyes, that she craves for more power and more and more and more, obviously. But can one person hold more magic? I don't think so. I don't think so. But if that's the case, I am pretty sure that Salem is trying to fuse all the maidens into one who is under them. And obviously she is using Cinder as well. That's so obvious. And I don't know how Cinder is not taking that. But we got more reason. Why is Watts following Salem at all? We got that from Raven, who probably saw it from her, got it from the informants that she has, and obviously she can turn into a Raven as well. So we know that Watts is an Atlassian scientist who, yes, has a doctorate, but we don't know in what. But it seems he is a machinist. That's not what I meant to say, because machinist is most likely the one who is in the front of the train. No. He's a mechanic. That's what I wanted to say. And not a doctor, I think. But if that's right, first of all, he was in Atlas. he was disgraced. That makes a lot of reason for him to. But basically, he is just a living dead person in Atlas. He is just a peasant now because he was disgraced. He's even worse in the eyes of the noble families or the Vaishni Das Company. If he was actually part of some big projects, obviously we know that he is really good. He made the Blackwing virus, we know that, and he is needed for replacing the tail of. Oh god, I forgot his name again, but you know what I mean. The Scorpion guy's tail. That means he is actually good at automailing or replacement body parts. Not only arms, but other mechanical stuff. And that is actually pretty much a big problem. Maybe he was in part of Penny's making, and that's why he was. That's why they knew her weaknesses. I don't know. Well, obviously we knew that they knew it from Ironwood, but I don't know. He either has some kind of grudge against Ironwood, against the Schnee family, or just Atlas in otherwise. But I was quite surprised when Raven suggested that, okay, I will do it if you kill my brother. Actually, it would make sense that she doesn't want anything else to be battered by, and her brother is basically the biggest threat for her, other than Salem. But after that, we got confirmation that this was actually a trap set by her. I'm pretty sure of it. Well, we are all sure of it because she said so that she wants the relic. But this was actually a trap that, thanks to Yang, she knows that Ruby is with Crow. She said Cinder up. She probably knows that Cinder was taken down by a little girl with a red hood. And she has quite the anger issues against her. Because, well, we saw later back in volume 4 that Cinder was actually training just to slay Ruby, just to get revenge for her arm and for her face, that she is actually hiding behind a black mask right now. I think that's a black mask. If that's not, that's just charred face and skin, and that's not happy thing. But I think that's a mask, because we see the scar under it. So yes, she was kind of burnt. So it seems Ruby's white, oh no, it her silver eyes skill actually turned her own fire against her. That's basically what happened, I think. But back to Raven. She set this up. First of all, she wants the relic for herself. She had no other chance but to accept it at that point, because if she says no, they will attack. She is actually just stalling right now, and at the last second we saw that she was flying away as a raven, opening a portal. We heard that portal sound, and flew right into where Crow is. But the thing is, that means she actually knows that Oscar is Ospin. And the question is she want to spy on Crow, or does she want to tell Crow about the little plan they have? Because if she sets this up very well, they can get Cinder, Mercury and everything, everyone. Or no, she actually doesn't want to fight. She want them to fight against each other, while in the chaos she grabs the relic and gets away. Well, she knows that she can't get away from Salem, but now she will have a great actual useful piece that she can use against her, other than the Spring Maiden, of course. But now I see what she's trying to do, but yeah, how she's thinking about Yang, that's not happy. That's definitely not what a mother would do. Well, most of the mothers, but as she said, she got her two options. She's either with Crow or with her. She gave her an option. She warned Yang that if she's gonna go with Crow, things are gonna happen, accidents, and there's gonna be war that she cannot win. And speaking about war, we have the other part, the exact opposite, where war is actually happening right now, the back alley war, where Gira is actually fighting valiantly, losing his aura, because it seems his werewolf panther form is actually making him more vulnerable, but more strong. Obviously, he's like hulking up, losing like strategic planning, but gaining more strength in order. And yes, he got he lost his aura. I think that's what that meant, or at least he blocked it. But speaking about aura, let's see. It doesn't seem like everyone can use it. I mean, the god didn't use it at all, or he already lost it beforehand. We got confirmed that everyone has aura, everyone has semblance. It's just a matter of time and practice that they can unlock it and use it as well. And we know from Ren that actually, and also been that maintaining a defensive aura is not actually easy from the get-go. You have to train to do it. So maybe they are just normal Faunus guards planned to fight against human enemies who are not actually attacking. They are just meant to guard the main head of Menagerie against protests and other stuff, not actually fight. But it seems that they can fight, obviously, and as I said, I liked their polar and their armor, which proved to be useful even though he died, that fall guard. And Gira was angry because of that, and obviously he's defending his family. But we saw Cossack and Fennec actually is complementing each other. They are separate beings. One has a fire dagger, I think that's a dagger, and the other one can cause cold wind. I think that's it. So it's basically the exact opposite which actually are complementing each other, and they can counter most of the elemental attacks with their own. They actually melted Blake's ice sculpture. And actually, I'm surprised that they came in time. Sun came in time to save Gira. Probably Gira wouldn't have died from that one guy with the assault rifle, but that was a great timing. But again, I have to say, why do you have to speak? Blake got this. If you didn't say, oh come on, faster, they wouldn't have just looked up and saw Blake. So much for the surprise. Come on, they were concentrating on you and Gira. Blake could have easily just gotten them out. And the other part is obviously when they were frozen, at least the hands were frozen in the sculpture. Thanks to dust images that Blake uses and the dust. I don't know where they got the dust, because there is a dust embargo. Or maybe not from Atlas, they obviously. But there are some other mines in other parts of the countries. But they are minuscule compared to the big Atlas Corporation, the Sneeders Company. But still, they could have easily taken them out, instead of speaking, oh no, go help your mother. We got this with you, with son, with my son-in-law. This is actually gonna be the part where Kira actually starts to like son. He obviously starting to get used to him. We know that he hated him, but I really, thanks to Sun being there, I'm not afraid that Gira is gonna die. But now I'm more afraid of Kali, because Blake is gonna fight in another place, and she is still alone, while the bad guy, Yuma, is she came with Ilya. He came with Ilya. We remember in the last episode, Ilya actually said, Yuma, you come with me. And that's when Sun rescued Blake, but still, that means he is there somewhere. Or either just reporting. I really hope that he is reporting Black to Adam, but I don't think that's the case. He's probably gonna attack Kali, who is actually doing a good job defending her house, hold, and her family as well. But still, it seems Blake is not gonna get there in time. I don't wanna see another death, at least not yet. Even though that would make, as I said beforehand, that would make the other furnace get together against the White Fang. Because it seemed that even though they are not with the idea to help humans, they liked Kali and Gira. They are actually cheering them on. Obviously, Gira is the leader of Menagerie. And they wouldn't just choose. I think they chose him as the leader. But again, they like Gira. If Gira Gira or Kali dies, that would set things in motion. That is for sure. Even though I don't wanna see that again. But it seems Blake chose. It seems Elias' trap actually proved that there are no words now. It's gonna happen. We have to fight. You are against me. I tried. When we saw Ilya. She is actually hesitating to grab her weapon. But Blake is already... Up. Weapon on. There we go. We are gonna fight. The words didn't help. I tried. I still hope there is hope for Ilya, though. I don't know. She is in love. She was in love with Blake. That was another surprise that we got before, but again, I don't know what's gonna happen. I actually don't know. As I said, I think Gira is gonna be okay, but Kali is gonna either get severely injured or die, and that would set things in motion. And I still don't know what Raven is gonna do, either just spying or telling them about all the plan. Oh, wait. If she chose sides, obviously, she knew that choosing sides, telling them that she is actually helping Salem opening the vault. Is it? Yes, it was called the vault. To get the relic. But actually, she's gonna take it. That would make her an enemy of Salem. And my enemy of the enemy is actually my friend. The only thing she can do is get the help of Ospin, Crow, and others. She might be a rogue one, but I think her heart might still get to one. The only thing that can save her clan. Obviously, we know that the clan is everything for her, even she left her family out. The family means nothing to her. At least the family that we say, the blood related thing. Her family is actually the tribe. And the tribe means everything. And the only best outcome, the only possible outcome for the tribe to survive is going with Ospin to helping Crow to get the relic. Well, yes, because if she doesn't help, they will just get the Spring Maiden or the power without her consent and just destroy the tribe. If she says she's gonna help, well, if she helps, they are gonna get discarded again, killed. Nothing is good gonna come from helping Salem, and she knows that as well. And yeah, I'm gonna assume that she is actually gonna go there, meet with Crow and probably Ospin as well. As she was there, she probably heard some, and Crow, we saw Crow looking out of the window upon hearing the Raven sounds outside. So I think he knows that Raven is there. Raven was always there, looking out for them. But yeah, I think she's gonna meet them, talk with them. That's why she wanted to spy on Cinder and the others where they are, what are they doing. So she would be sure that they wouldn't know that she's actually talking to Crow. And that would make things much, much easier for all of them. Actually, all of them. That they would know that Lionheart is actually not safe to be trusted. And they actually know it already, but still. Again, that was a really eventful episode. And well, eventful as in not really. Not much happened. It's like in this episode, which was 15 minutes long, the action was actually like 2 minutes here and 2 minutes there at the same time happening. That was it. So there was not a lot of things to go on with, but a lot of things that are meaningful. So I hope you like this review. I think I gotten through everything I wanted to. And oh wait, I forgot that we never saw for, I don't actually know which one is Forsak and which one is Fennec, but we never saw that one without the hood. We never saw them before without that, and I really thought that he Gira impaled him with the lens. That would have been much, much more enjoyable. And actually, that makes me kind of sad that the other one was actually worried about him. It seems they still have feelings, and I don't know if they are just still doing this for the greater good. As I said before, I think they are actually using Adam. Those two are using Adam. And they questioned if killing Gira and Kali is for the greater good or not, or Adam is actually the good choice to be the leader. It seems they chose him. So I don't know if they are gonna go through with it, even though I'm pretty sure Kira is ready to kill at this point. He gave away every last bit of self-restraint when they actually killed his guard and obviously most likely his friend. So there is not gonna be so much redemption for them, sadly. But Ilya is still savable, if not too late. But now I think everything is said that I wanted to say. So yeah. I don't think I wanna say anything else. Unless, except that, thank you for watching and being here, and I hope you like this review. This was not a reaction. I wanted to say reaction so badly. But thank you for being here, and see you next time with another review and reaction. Bye bye.